Before we play, I want to thank my friends on the stage. One of the most awkward questions you can ask of someone is, would you play on a trombone recital? Right? So, we've been doing this piece on Nebraska Chamber Players concerts, and I really wanted to do it on this recital, and they were so kind to come down to town and play, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate it, so this is going to be fun.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Don't tell my wife, but for this piece I have to take my wedding ring off. Right? You know what I'm gonna tell her? All right. Thank you. Randy Snyder, is composer emeritus here at the School of Music. And Randy wrote so much music for me over the years and continues to write music, and it's all brilliant and it's all challenging, and I love it all. This is one of my favorites. We did this piece this summer at the International Trombone Workshop. We've done it at all number of venues, and it's just terrific. I don't honestly know what I'm gonna do when Randy decides he doesn't wanna do this with me anymore, because you'll see, reciting Kerouac in rhythm and in meter is, it looks hard and it is hard. And I don't know anyone else who can do what Randy does. I appreciate him coming and performing on the recital, and I appreciate everything he's done for me over the, how many years now? 23, 24, let's not think about it. A lot of years. So thanks, Randy.
Following Lee Konitz, the famous alto jazz man down the street. I don't even know before. Saw him first in that bar on the northeast corner of 49th and 6th Avenue, which is a real old building that nobody ever notices because it forms the pebble at the hem of the shoe of the immense tall man, which is the RCA building. I noticed it only the other day while standing in front of Howard Johnson's eating a cone. Or rather, it was too crowded for me to get a cone. And I was just standing there, and I was thinking, New York is so immense that it would make no difference to anybody's ass if this building exists and is old. Lee, who wouldn't talk to me even if he knew me, was in the bar, from which I've made many phone calls, waiting with big eyes for his friend to show up. And so I waited on the corner to think. And soon I saw Lee coming out with his friend who'd arrived. It was Arnold Fishkin, the Tristano bass player. Two little Jewish Kazowski fellows they were, really. As they cut across the street, and Konitz, in that manner that was forceful, and I said to myself, he can take care of himself. Even though he goofs in this April in Paris from inside out as if the tune was the room he lived in and was going out at midnight with his coat on. But I haven't heard him for weeks and weeks. Both of them real small among the crowds. Fishkin is 5'3" or such, and Conan's 5'6" or such. Cutting along, so I follow. And they turn west at 48th. Across the street, temporarily bemused, first for a sign for a large furnished room with cooking clothes and bath in a beast sort of hidden tenements back at the cut of Midtown. But how could I live there or even be like Lee Konitz, cutting around the world of men and women when my father told me to take care of my mother on his deathbed? These my thoughts. And where do you think they go? But Manny's, the music store of hipsters and Symphony Sid, but which, however, at this moment, and strangely connected with the feeling I had had while waiting for Konitz, looking over big buildings and see Atlantic clouds blowing in from sea and realizing sea is bigger even than New York and that's where I ought to be, is filled with a whole crew of sailors, apparently in the store, to buy equipment for a big whale goon papa Navy band. And Konitz goes completely unrecognized by them. Although the Danny Richmond-like owners know Lee so well, they don't say to him, as I would,
"Where are you playing now, great genius?"
They say,
"When you leaving?"
knowing already of his road plans. Lee buys reeds or such in a box, almost but not quite big enough for an alto, and already packed and waiting for him. And then he and Fishkin cut around the corner as they follow a sea of crowds to a mysterious marble lobby of big office buildings and cut right upstairs on foot. And in fact, a whole bunch of hip-looking guys are coming to do the same, avoiding elevators and a study board to find out big deal on second floor or third walk-up floor. But nothing. So the mystery remains, though I still say it must be a music school. And this was typical of my lostness and loneliness. I go around dressed like a bum with a CD envelope. Have no Fishkins to walk with. Unless I'm drunk. And spend my time watching the frenetic lights of Times Square, the huge current, Quo Vadis montage that goes up almost as high as Astor Hotel roof. A blue light woman tied to a stake that goes higher than her head in blue light Aries. And neons burning a painting of Rome that has in an 18th century tenements of Pittsburgh by Georgia. And also Greek Parthenons. MGM presents on white neons. Then huge Quo Vadis lighting up first ordinary. Then running, then blinking, then shivering, then in the climax, running, blinking, shivering, as if coming, and this time is bigger than next doors. 10 tall men, which is big enough and biggest I ever saw, till Quo Vadis. And I am lonely and small in all this. Good night.
In the spring of 1996, I auditioned for my job here, and I lucked out because I was able to work with Michael Cotton. He was my accompanist for my audition. Since then, we've done 24 recitals together here at UNL, and it's just one of the pleasures of my life to play with Michael Cotton, and I can't thank him enough. He's a great coach and mentor, and he's taught me a lot about music, and I appreciate it. I also want to thank you all for coming out. It means a great deal to me to have this many people to come out for a trombone recital. And by the way, if you're not busy, the next orchestra concert will actually feature a trombone solo concerto, so come out for that as well. And then in December, we're going to do another trombone concerto with the symphonic band, so come to that too. It's all trombone, all the time.
Thank you. Thank you.